Hello everyone and welcome back to this Let's Play Total War Warhammer 2 with our legendary Lord Krokgar. 15's worth more than the 6 reduction. Alright, that's from here. Fortifications. Again. Oh, and we're out of money. Oh no, we're out of growth, not money. We've got plenty of money. They've got money, all the things. So here's the stonemaker with it. Actually, the money making building first, then stonemaker second. Skink feathers. We're all happy here. Come off, March. Get in there, and then we're going to start recruiting you an army. An army! Right, enough of the pig snorting. Right. First of all, let's get me Ancient Stegodon and a Bastillodon. A couple of Temple Guard. And 1, 2, 3, 4 Horned Ones. There we go, that's a few turns worth of recruitment to say the least. Keep force marching up, because everything important is up in this area. This is the hardest settlement to protect, to be honest. So having these Krokgar and this guy over here will help quite a bit, and then I've got these three over here. Let's have a look over here. Any money making stuff to build? Any money makers to build? Any money makers to build? I don't think so. So I think we got our first end turn. We already put his skill up. Alright, since there's nothing else to build this turn, I'm gonna straight into start getting some other stuff. 2, 4 of them. That's all my money gone, and my money's gonna plummet. But if we are coming across another whole wave in 2 turns, I'm gonna be thankful I put a wee bit of extra into recruitment. Next time we can colonize here again. Then we're laughing. Right, is there anyone new to trade with? Why are we not trading? Demand a payment. Low. High. Low. Let's edit the value manually then. 7. Moderate. Accepted. Brilliant. Every little penny we can squeeze out of the AI will help me. Oh, these guys can trade again.
The words of Athaloran welcome you. Deliver your message.
Still high. Moderate.
I concur.
He concurs. Right. Speaking of. Wee bit extra turn, which is quite good. Mm-hmm. Quite nice. Technology, what am I researching? Oh, brilliant. Temple Guard, going to get even stronger. That's for everything else. Yeah, everything else seems good. Let's end turn. And we're back. I've got a ranking up for this little skinky here. He has his Ancient Stegodon already. He's already got all this stuff. I really want Arcane Vessel. He's one level away from it though. Let's get him Curse. Texture of the old ones. Missile resistance. Might be really good against stuff like Warp Lightning Cannons actually. Missile resistance, that's the one I was looking for. I like how Agility of the Lizard. I'm just trying to imagine an Ancient Stegodon, like. Because he's now on an Ancient Stegodon, so those two abilities don't match up well. Like, I can understand it when he's a little skink. Like, Agility of the Lizard, like, what was it? A Warp Lightning Cannon's about to fire at him, and like, skitters to the side a wee bit, and then, like, just misses him. But an Ancient Stegodon, what's it meant to do? Like, boom, boom. Like, the cannon's gonna fire on Agility the Lizard, just like boom, boom, boom. They go over to the side. I just find it quite funny. I just see like an ancient Stegron lumbering along, then the cannon goes to fire and it sort of skirts up a little tree and like, ee! Yeah. Okay. Back to the game. Move over there. You do a wee bit of colonization. Colonize. Province secured. Which means I can put that one back on. The alignment of crafting. Gives me more money. Hey, did I bump that over here too? Oh, it was auto done for me. Must have. I don't know. Why? Yeah, yeah. Income, growth, public order. Happy days. Right, he's not done anything yet, so we can now use global recruitment on this guy to get him. Most importantly, it would be some Saurus with shields. And after that, that's all my money's gone. Oh, and Larry's got a ranking up. The slinky and the pain, and Larry. The slinky and the pain, and Larry. Leadership, not really wanting to get him. I feel like that's a wee bit wasted. Speed. Oh, wait, Agility the Lizard. Now that is not as funny on a Carnosaur, but you gotta admit, it's still a funny thought. Just seeing a Carnosaur just quickly skitter out of the way. Because I imagine that's what it's meant to be. Like the skinks, yeah, they are small, skittery type things. And it's like, skitter out of the way, skitter out of the way. For some reason, I don't think it's funny on a Bastillodon. Like, Bastillodons just don't have... I don't know what it is. Bastillodons are even less skittered out of the way than Stegodons. Well then, maybe a bit the same as an ancient Stegodon. But... I just don't find it as funny as a Stegodon. Just something about a Stegodon going... running away just makes me... I just like that. Right, I think that's time to end turn again. Our research will be done. What race have we got actually? Slime Mage Priest? Meh. I'm not big on Mage Lords. I'll explain why. That's why. These skills are skills that I really badly want. And if I'm wanting those skills right away, I can't put them into the Mage skills area, which you really need for a mage to be effective. Like, how powerful is a mage if he can only cast Vaisen's Wild Form? Not that powerful. Yes, alright, let's end turn.
A relic to turn the cogs of the world and bring alignment lay beyond the great falls of Astego. A key would be discovered, one to unlock knowledge both welcome and unwanted. The fabric of reality was torn. From the realm of ruin, the Skaven's horned god mocked its prey and revealed his plan. The celestial event that weakened the vortex was of Skaven design. A parody of the true comet. The Council of 13, the Ratmen's highest authority, were architects of this grand manipulation. Its task complete and fuel expended. The rocket fell back to the surface. When the wreckage was discovered, its purpose remained unclear until now. It was the catalyst to weaken the vortex and goad the other races into action. They knew the reptiles would seek to bolster the failing vortex, but they were ready. Every ritual cast, the magic was stolen, absorbed into the horned rat's bell. Now soaked in ritual power, the bell will be moved to Ulthuan's heart. If it tolls 13 times, the horned god shall emerge from the vortex, the world doomed. Then the god was gone. Alignment is close, but Sotek's nemesis may yet bring ruin upon us all.
The insidious Skaven seek to bring their terrible god into this world, mighty lord. This must not come to pass. Continue your course of action.
Crush that is a lot of Skaven.
And take control of the vortex for yourself.
They're all the way up here though, so they've got a long way to get it down. Spider presence. Gonna try and create a area where I'm beefed up to no end there. And keep him there in case there's a ritual happens. Oh, the elves have started their ritual again. Never even noticed when they did that. You're gonna keep recruiting. Camp. First of all, upgrade. Resource. More money. Then over here. Global recruitment. Another 2 units of skinks. A couple units of carnosaur. Croxagores, not carnosaurs, that wish. And I'm gonna have the 4 armies here to try and defend. I still don't like my odds against it was what, 8 or 9? And they were all gonna be like gold chevroned, etc., etc. But I need to stop them from getting to here. Here and here. That's the places they cannot get to. I don't mind if they take anywhere else, but as long as it's not those three. Those three no-nos. I just want to see another. Oh, it's Elven style. Yeah, they all have that wee thing. Okay, I was just wondering if it was because they were doing the ritual, they had that weird sort of floaty bit. So I hadn't noticed that before. But yes, let me intern again. And we're back. Well, that's quite fortunate, actually. Extra, because we've already got Winds of Padre. It was plus 10, wasn't it, or something? So that'll be plus 24 for the other monk, and I'm not that bothered about the monk. Ranking up here. Crowd warriors. Over here we go. I really need that, but I doubt we're going to get it in time.
You old god.
You go over there to chill beside Croxagar. Croxagar? Long Crocgore. I There's no sign of the Skaven. They did start like all the way up here, so it's gonna take them a good like 1, 2, 3 turns to get here. Four turns to get here.
Aye, tok tok.
I've got my four armies, I'll keep them clumped together and hopefully they spread their armies out. Hopefully they come across like wide areas and we can just sort of like bam 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 take them apart piecemeal. Because if they don't, I'm actually a wee bit worried. We need skinks. That's what we need. So we're going to get this turn. He may move out as well to come over and help. And I really don't want to move this guy out. I want him to stay there to protect the capital in case they attack. Send another thingy. A McThingy. I'm running low on money. Yes, this will be another end turn. And we're back. The troll skulls have been destroyed. Oh well. We failed some sort of mission. Missions are the last things on my mind right now. Defenses. That sort of thing is the first. Golden tower up. Nearly out of money. This is the last few bits, give me a couple of skinks. Save the last wee bit of money. Still no sign of still no sign of all those Skaven. Dun 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 dun. Don't know why it was that theme, but look at them. They're all on Force March. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 stacks. All 20 with Lords probably about level 40. I don't feel so confident about this. Holy moly, that's a lot of Skaven. You failed. At least only two of them have a bell. Foolish thing. No. 40 general. 37 general. 40 general. 40 general. 40 general. 40 general. 38 general. Oh, it's just not fair. So many generals, so many skills, and they're all gold chevron. That's not fair. Right. What level's Larry? 29. Yeah, he does have immortality, doesn't he? Right, brilliant. So, because I'm thinking this is probably all going to die to just bleeding that down to manageable levels. I think we're probably going to lose absolutely everything here. But the important things is... Yeah, good, he's got immortality as well. Oh, the place that's going to hurt is losing this guy, Tepti. Because he doesn't have immortality yet. The rest... They're replaceable. The rest are easily replaceable. But the only one that's going to hurt is Tepti. And then once obviously they're all gone, I'll use that to bleed damage drives. Oh, they are taking attrition. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, these necromancer guys. They're taking attrition. That's just going to soften them up that wee bit. Hopefully that'll help. Right, nothing to do, but oh, what's this all about? Oh yeah, I don't care about that. Don't care about the next one sitting still. Right, I'll see you all in a minute. And we're back. We had a war breakout somewhere over here, I think. Let me take a look. Yep, I do not have time to deal with that. Let's pay, because this area was starting to make me good amounts of money. But there's literally no way I have time to defend against these armies. They actually didn't even declare war on me. It was actually quite annoying. They declared war on these guys over here that I had to enter. Well, I should have actually just declined. But, oh well, too little, too late. I didn't think of that at the time. I was just like, right, okay. Yeah. That's not what's important anymore. Appears this guy got stronger as he was walking down. Oh, just look at that. Look at the attrition they've taken. Isn't it beautiful? Right, there's only four armies here, so where'd the other so many go? They must be coming across here, planning to come down this way. So, I've got another turn where they're probably going to force march even further down. They're not going to take any more attrition. Well, they're going to take attrition. No, they're not going to take any more attrition after this because they'll move and then not be taking attrition. Well, let's just make sure everyone's in range of the city and of each other. Because they're not going to be able to attack this city this turn, but just in case. I'm actually going to move Krokgar outside of the city, because if they besiege the city then attack the guys outside, he's not going to be able to help the guys outside. He's the main army to do so, and I'm not going to put that up. But actually, if they're only bringing the four armies straight down, maybe the other two are heading over this way. They'll take more attrition, and their attrition's actually done quite a nice bit of damage. Against four armies, it's questionable, but I think I may be able to win. I really could not tell you. But then again, I'm thinking, yeah, if all my armies were like Krokgar's army, I'm like, yeah, I've got this in the bag. But the fact is, they're gold chevron storm vermin with lots of buffs from their generals. Makes my other armies, I'm like, this storm vermin and that are just gonna chew right through. That's the problem. I've got no answer. Krokgar's troops are an answer for them, but apart from that, no real answer. Those horned ones are gonna be invaluable. Look at that. Look at those rank 9 horned ones with the upgrades from Krokgar. Oh, just look at that. 52 melee attack. Oh. 86 speed. Lovely. Lovely. Right, okay. Right, I'm procrastinating here. Because I'm scared. I'm scared. Right, let's do this. Right, I managed to intercept one of them going into the underground. Which, if this was Krokgar's army, I'd have probably been overjoyed with. But this army, I think I'm going to decline it and see if I can try and be a wee bit smarter, choose my battles. This might be a big mistake. You know what, we'll make a quick save here. Because if I change my mind, I want to come back and fight this. Actually, you know what, not a quick save because I might save over that. Before under battle. Saved. Some game decline. Because I didn't even know that. Oh, that is lovely. And they do have a lot of artillery. So, I think I'm going to now quick save. And I'm going to auto resolve because I think that artillery will be able to take heavy losses on stuff. We lost one unit of Croxagores. What? I can live with that and then get lots of replenishment. Another underway interception. Decline, because we're now going to have a numbers advantage. Oh, decline. Whoa. Because I think I'm going to be able to check, pick and choose now. Bit better. Opposing ritual started in the ground. ranking up for Slinky in the Pain, which is rather pointless. So I'll move him there. Move him. Into the settlement then. Krogar attacks this guy. Do we have the reinforcements from everyone? Boom! We do. And they've got their three armies. 1, 2, 3, 4. We've only got the four. But we do have the garrison. Reinforcement, reinforcement. So one's not getting in. So, shoot for now. What one wasn't getting in? Or is there a max of four armies? One, two. I think this little one wasn't getting in, so I think there's a max of four armies. Alright, so we're gonna make a new quick save here. Actually, no, we'll make a full save. Before huge battle. And this battle would cover about five parts if I fought it. So I really do not want to fight it, but we may end up having to, because look at the numbers. We're going to have about 2,000 Skaven there, about 2,000, well, probably about 3,000 Skaven there, about 3,000 Skaven there, about 3,000 Skaven there, so that's about 9,000 Skaven versus probably similar numbers of me. The lag, I'm probably going to get like half a frame a second, even though there's only going to be 20 units on the field at one time. You know what I mean? They're just going to keep streaming in every time they lose a unit. I'm just going to keep streaming in every time I lose a unit. And it's just going to take goddamn awful. Boom. And we got a close victory. And it doesn't look like we took too many losses. So that is brilliant. And that's three of their six or so armies gone. They've got two left there. Krogar himself ranked up. Oh, this is brilliant. Destroyer of Skaven. It is really good, but only when you're fighting Skaven. I want to get that. Those guys are thingied now. I pity I don't have any blessed spawnings. Now we'll do Larry's first. Larry's going to get... Larry's running out of things to get too. Spread public order, assault garrison, wounded, and specialist. Larry's just going to get his speed up. As for you, Crocky, old buddy, old pal. Armor. So we'll go for the armor. And no one else got a rank up. I'm actually surprised by that. I was really hoping that that Tepti might get a rank up. Krogar. There, do we have the numbers to now try and take them on here now? They've only got two armies. So, I think we do. Again, take the replenishment. All the money! Money for all the days. Got an ogre blade. Now, Tepti's got a rank up. Still not high enough for that. I'll get him as Pterodon. Because he can get. That's not Tepti. Where's the guy we were calling Tepti that was close to. That's Tepti. Well, they aren't. We're looking at this. I'm so confused. Where's the guy we weren't wanting to lose? This is him here. Yeah, Teptes. He's got the same name as this guy. That's why I was so confused. We're on a different army. And then I was like, wait a minute, that's Teptes? Right, this is Teptes. I was like, but he's level like 18 now. Why can he not get Arcane Vessel on this? Yeah, that makes sense now, because we weren't looking at that Teptes. We're looking at this Teptes and his Slinky Winky. Slinky Winky. Ugh. I don't want to think about a slink with a winky. I need to think about what I say before I say it, before I just make things. Windmaker me, please. Slinky. Right, I think they've got one more army out there somewhere at least. But where is it? Oh, and I've got money for days. Look at all this money. Money, 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 money. Money, 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 money. So much money, it's very funny. Right, do I have the range to... Oh, I really wish we had the range to get Krokgar into the settlement or thingy so he could global recruit. I suppose he could global recruit and pass them over. I wish we could get some blessed units in there. Money this turn, what needs spent? Oh, that can get bought. And this construction slot. Give me that. B as well. I've got money coming out of the cojones. Not that much money coming out of the cojones. It's for here, this area is all as good as gone. So yeah, I'm probably better off saving that money so I can actually. I want to bring this guy back. Over. Right. Let's say. Oh, this will be a part, actually. So, hope you've all enjoyed this. Join me all next time, where I think we're finally gonna get. I think we've won this. I think we have. I think what we're gonna do is take really good units from these other armies and pass them over to Krokgar. So that, he doesn't have to spend as long recruiting. And I think we're just going to want all Temple Guard all the time. No basic little guys, just all Temple Guard. We'll do that then now, actually. Here, have my Temple Guard, Krokgar. And here, Krokgar. Have these Temple Guard too. Apart from that... Oh yeah, have this blessed spawn, Saurus Warriors, too. That's him at 18. He's got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 melee units. 4 range, the 4... is take... this ancient Stegdon and this Bastildon with Soul Engine. There we go, Krokgar's at max strength already, and Larry's gonna start training the silver chevrons. Hopefully we can get them to gold. Gold, gold! And Krokgar has a very powerful army for the final battle. And the others can just re-recruit. We're ranking up over here too. Earthing. And right! Oh, what's this tell me about? Yeah, we'll get that up. Right! I hope you've all enjoyed this. The end is in sight! We'll probably have another one or two parts of this campaign, then we've won! Hope you've all enjoyed this! Join me all next time. See you all there. Bye-bye.